your jeans.
Why?
Because I want to see you in your panties.
My panties?
Don't worry, I don't want your pussy. What's the matter? They have little hearts on them? No, wait. Teddy bear.
Please. This has been one of the worst days of my life. The worst. The worst.
You still want to make documentary of me, don't you?
Yes, I have to. But they evicted me. Everything in my apartment carted out to the street. My things, all my things are gone. My life is junk on the street.
Before, people came and picked through your things like maggots. And they already have so much anyway, these maggots, but still it was just on the street. People strange, turning into scavengers. They took a lot of your things away. So a lot of your things will adorn the apartments of others. Take some consolation.
My books, my prints, my clothes, my pottery from Colombia, my rug from Tunisia. I slept on the street for that rug. I wanted that rug, and all I had money for was a hotel room or that rug. But I bought the rug, and I stayed on the street, and now it's gone.
Things go, they lost, they burned, they are stolen. You live, I live, barely, but we live.
I just feel like my soul has been ripped away. My life is just bags of trash. Oh God, no, this can't be. This can't be happening. My apartment, my beautiful little apartment, this is so unfair.
What happened to you? Barely scratches the surface of the meaning of the word unfair.
Hey, I got your camera and lights and the stand you wanted. It's in the truck. What's wrong, baby?
My apartment. Had me and everything thrown out of my apartment. I got evicted, Trish. While I was at your place after I came out of the hospital. See, some of it's still out there.
What?
Look!
Those are your clothes. I gave you that red sweater for your birthday. It looked beautiful on you. Now it's in the gutter, knotted up in dirty water.
They can't do that to you. It's illegal. You were sick. You were under doctor's orders.
This was on my door.
You're 6 months in arrears and arrest. You have ignored my letters and letters from my lawyer. I'm within my legal right to have you evicted. Since you cannot be located, your apartment has been officially deemed abandoned. Everything in the apartment was disposed of according to law. They can't do this.
I went to legal aid and they said she was within her right. That fucking old cunt had me and all my belongings, my clothes, everything, stuffed into garbage bags and dragged to the curb. My wicker chairs and sofa all hauled away. My beautiful little rent-controlled apartment that I had for 9 years with all my things, my clothes, my books, my art, my paintings, stuffed into garbage bags. I'll never get back in the East Village with the rents they charge now. That was a once-in-a-lifetime apartment. Look! That street person!
He has my whole bound collection of Dostoevsky novels. He's taking them away! I love those. I've had them since college. I'm going to get them back.
Let them go. Hindrances. Look at them as clutter. Clutter is being cleaned out of your life.
And what do you find so amusing about this?
Everything.
Excuse me?
Vlad says...
Don't apologize for me. I am often misunderstood. I have an, let's say, dark view of life. I have experienced the cruelties of life and death of life. We are still savages. Slightly civilized, but still savages. Just a mere veneer covers our bloodlusts and hungers.
Land... I have to pick up my little girls for dance class. It's my turn to drive the carpool.
That old drunk will only spit at you. Say that they are his because he found them in garbage. He will fight you for them. then he will sell them for a dollar on the street.
Those are hard-bound books I've had since college.
The irony. Do you not see the irony with Dostoevsky? Hmm? The gambler, the idiot, Crime and Punishment. See it? Do you not see it?
I was the gambler. I was the idiot. I did the crimes, and I must accept the punishment.
You see. Now you are beginning to see.
I have your camera, and lights, and all the copies of your films in my basement. They're really valuable things.
Those are just copies. My masters, the ones I need to do editing with and make good copies from, are gone. Copies of copies never look good.
Whoa, that documentary you did of the dying off of the clamming industry at Chesapeake Bay, the one that she won those two awards for, they're not in our basement?
No. I took them home and put them back in my file cabinet. Nigel said he might have an investor, so I wanted the best copy for him to show.
Genius thought he had something going, huh?
Another investor. How many have there been? Oh, my baby sister, I pray. I pray that someday you get to make your film. It means so much to you, and you have given so much, but you have lost so much. How much more are you going to give for that film of yours?
I have no child, no husband, no grandchildren for mom. I'm sorry, Trish, it's just what I have to do.
Have to? You got so sick this last time.
My movie is my child, my husband, my life. I know you don't understand that, but it's true for me.
I saw them put the file cabinet on the truck and haul it off.
Something that valuable. I told you to keep it with me. I always thought something could happen to that little place of yours. Could catch fire or something. But it's gone.
Big movie producer was going to get that one done for you.
Baby, you were in the hospital for 3 weeks and they do this to you. Throw you out the street. Mom is going to be so upset about this. We are not telling her you were evicted. You just had to move because the building was sold and they're knocking it down to build a high rise or something. Oh, that man you were living with. Where is he? Where was he? Why did he stop this? The one you said was definitely going to produce your film?
The great producer.
I don't know where he is.
Our fine boy. In crisis, I think he gets scared and runs.
I can't find him. I don't know where he is. He won't call me back.
Oh, you lost your producer. And such a great one at that.
Look, I know you're supposed to be famous, but this is obviously not the time. Look at my sister. You know how hard it's been for her.
Her choice. These are circumstances she created for herself. Now she lives painful consequences.
Oh, thank you for your sympathy. My sister is in terrible shape, and that's what you have to say.
I am an absurdist, an atheist, a nihilist, but most of all, pragmatist. Decisions, actions, results. Live with it.
Hey, you forgot cynical and mean. Don't.
No. Don't stop her. She's being honest. Actually, April is used more often, and enraged, even more. I engage in unprovoked little cruelties games. They just come over me. Perhaps it's my Middle European blood. Maybe I am from the tribe of Attila. It gives me surge. Not sexual, mind you, but still, surge. I find power in certain demands. I know what you want to do to me. Admit it. You want to kill me for telling you the truth.
Just his way. That's why his work is so intense. The sculpture he's working on now is going to London in front of the Hall of International Peace.
Must give the bourgeois public its token, its empty gesture to rinse away the guilt for letting the Serbs do their hunting on my people as your civilized world stood by and watched for so long.
Vlad's family.
Correction. Lack of family.
Why didn't you tell me you were so far behind in your rent? We could have done something.
Nigel told me he was paying it all along.
And all along he was just adding up the eviction notice.
You know him.
Nigel? Sure. Everyone knows Nigel. He was living in cardboard condo in Park before your sister let them move in with her. He used to shower himself by running back and forth through children's sprinkler.
You just let him move in? You told me he was a movie producer. You said it was a miracle that you found him. He was the one getting you those pills. Wasn't he?
He was her lifeline, her medicine man. But he did produce some films, so you let the ones I filmed. Your sister, very impressive filmmaker.
What little films is he talking about, Lynn? I don't want to talk about them.
I thought some of them were outstanding. She and Nigel would use my studio to shoot. Your gift, mwah, is for the lights. You always wanted to get up on lather and adjust an angle while Nigel, great producer, yelling, get the dick! Just get the dick!
Get the dick?
Dick. Stop, I said.
Why be ashamed? You make some nice movies with Nigel Natarajan.
It's no more about them.
Well, where are they?
Nigel, fed up them. Stores on 42nd Street. Make himself some nice little money.
Why wasn't he paying the rent with that money?
I don't know. He was always working on a deal or something.
Yeah, but they always came back with their sacred pills, huh? And you paced like a little animal till he did.
Oh, well, that's over. The pill thing is over. You were in serious trouble. You could have died.
Right now, I wish I did.
Oh, Lance, stop that talk. Oh, God, the kids. I'm going to be late.
I wouldn't be draining you, Trish, if I weren't...
Alive? Stop it, Land. Don't think about it. You got seriously addicted, but it's over and you're okay and staying that way. And you're living with me until you get back on your feet.
The more Land and her problems, the insanity and the chaos. Everyone wants me to be just like you. Just like Mother and Daddy would want. Another you. But I can't.
Stop carrying on.
You don't understand me. Mom and Dad didn't. I'm just who I am. Huh. I can't help it.
No. You're right. I don't understand. I don't understand you. Letting a man living in a park move in with you and getting you pills. And you thought he was paying the rent? No. You're right. I don't understand. But it's been an unbearable morning, so we'll discuss it later.
He loved my script. He loved it. Nigel said it was the most touching thing he'd ever read. He said he wanted to produce it and he had money. He loved it.
He was looking for a place to move into. If he had money to produce your film, why was he living in a park?
He told me he had money. That he had property in Europe that he sold for $200,000.
Yes, Nigel and his property. Problem is money never quite makes sense.
Man, you keep letting him live with you and getting you those pills.
She took them.
She was vulnerable and sensitive and very hurt. Because some mysterious Korean who was going to do her film backed out.
Like all the rest.
Yeah. She took those pills, I know. So you can't fully blame him. But he certainly didn't do anything to help her. Of course he needed a place to move into, so he had a vested interest in keeping her incapacitated.
She looked like a grown woman for me, weak, but grown.
I love it. Every time someone says they love your script, you let them use you and abuse you. This guy was just one more.
I thought he was for real. He had legal papers, deeds. He always had a problem getting his money, a mix-up at the bank overseas. But he was gonna get a check any day. And the day he got his money, your sister would start shooting. I was ready. I had the actors, the perfect actors, and the locations, everything to make my movie. My movie. I wrote it and rewrote it. It's so perfect.
Don't talk about it anymore. He doesn't have anything for you. And you'll just wait around and hope.
She just kept believing him. Nigel is very good at making people believe him. He's a beguiler.
And getting pills that almost killed you.
My movie, Trish. He said we just had to survive until the transfer of an international check. That they were holding it up for a political reason. That they put a hold on all his money because they had to make sure it wasn't being secretly funneled into a terrorist account. But any day it was going to come to his bank account here. Any day, he said. Any day.
He said he was paying the rent. And look how that turned out. Look at that mess in the street. God, why do people do things like that to other people? That is why I do not live in this city.
Yes, you live where things are clean and well organized and everything fits together at perfect right angle.
Yes. The suburbs, if that's what you mean, where people work and are decent and raise families. We have a community. I know you hate them, Land.
I don't hate them. They're fine for you. The PTA, soccer games, and swimming classes. Me, I feel dead when I'm there.
When you were a kid, all you did was run away. Because you had to get to the city and hang out with that punk crowd. Mom and Dad would be worried sick until you walked through that door. Anyway, it's getting late. Let's just see if we can go outside and salvage some of the clothes from those bags. I can wash them in the machine at home.
I had to make my movie, Trish.
Even if it kills you?
Was it the anxiety of waiting for Nigel's money to come? I was going off the pills as soon as we started shooting. We just had to live. Oxy was going on the streets for a minimum of $20 a pill. We needed money. That's why I had to shoot those stupid little movies for him.
What movies are you talking about, Land? Why haven't I seen them? Land, I'm your sister. Talk to me, Land.
Quickie little porns. Nigel knew what he could sell them to.
You were making pornography? My sister!
You didn't have to say it, Vlad.
What? You make nice little films. Why are you ashamed? Bartenders across the street, you had them dress up, act like tigers.
I don't want to talk about them.
Please, they enjoyed it. Nigel paid them off with coke. The fucking fatties are fucking fatties. That was my
favorite. Stop it!
Hey, I was art director. I'm proud of that one.
Please.
300-pound nurses, drunk and crazy, tourists from Kansas, Nigel rolling back and forth, fucking them, we pour flour on top, and then it all starts to get...
Stop it! Oh, you are coming home with me, now!
No, Trish, not now. Not today. I'm shooting a documentary with Vlad today.
You were too weak and upset to do anything! You were just thrown out of your apartment! You are coming home with me, now, Land.
No, Trish, I'm going to shoot Vlad today while he works on his art and talks about his life.
I told you you could. If you take off your jeans.
Vlad, not now. Please
take off your jeans?
Trish, I showed you that section on Vlad in the Times. He's the hottest artist in town. Remember, the critic said he could almost see blood coming out of his work. He's in, really in. He's big in the art world. Everyone is on him. He's international. His work is a symbolic protest against the Serb atrocities. I'm going to shoot him while he's working. He talks about it while he works, so it'll fit together beautifully. Then I'll edit it and get it into the Village Voice Film Festival. It's huge. Lots of coverage. I can get noticed with a film on him. He's a name. If I could win or pick up a little buzz at least, I can start to get backing for my movie.
You're shaking, Land. Do it another time.
No, the deadline is tomorrow. I've got to shoot it now into the night, then edit it early in the morning and get it over to The Voice by 6. That's why I needed you to bring my camera and lights. I could grab another prize. I already have one for the Chesapeake Bay. I could get a name. Financing. I could get financing for By Love and Art Scarred. Today is the only day I have left.
No, you are too sick. You are coming home. You don't even have a place to stay here.
I'll sneak into the film school late tonight. I'll find a couch. I can stay there. I'll get the first editing bay in the morning.
I am going to work. If you are going to shoot, shoot or go.
You were in intensive care 2 weeks ago, Land. You have been hustled out of your apartment. The doctor wanted you to go into a program for 6 months. You're still detoxing from those pills. You
You need to come with me.
Baby, please, come home.
A name for myself. This is a chance to get my movie back.
You are coming home where it is safe, where you can sleep in a normal bed.
No. Help me get my camera and equipment up here, please. I've got to start shooting. You heard him. He's going to start working. I have to get him from the beginning. I have to start.
Just a minute, Vlad. Just let me get my equipment up here and set up.
I don't know if I want to do this anymore. I am not in the mood to talk anymore. Maybe you better go with your sister.
You promised me. You promised me you'd do this. I've got to shoot it. You tell her no so I can get her back to my place? She's too sick.
Vlad, you promised. You promised you'd do this for me.
Either start or to go. But you two are beginning to bother me.
Quick, Trish, help me get the camera.
Oh, no. You are coming with me. We are getting whatever clothes we can salvage.
Go. You won't take off your jeans anyway.
Take off your jeans? Why? Sex? Is that why?
I only want her to fill me in her panties. I have no desire for intercourse. A little power game, call it. A small token of her appreciation.
Vlad does things like this.
Sometimes. Just a little nakedness. It makes me feel comfortable. No. Not comfortable. Dominant.
He's a genius. He's eccentric. Picasso did things like this.
Oh, yeah, well, he's no Picasso, and you are not stripping down to your panties.
No big deal.
Oh, you're just on a sick little power trip, all because you're famous for your blood-gushing sculptures.
Good. That's good. That's exactly what I want. That bridge bitch on the Upper East Side, she told me to take a shower before the first time I fuck her. She say, I smell bad. I say, you want to fuck me, then you take my dirt and smell. Now, she begs me to come over and fuck her when I am all dirty and smelly. She now desires animal. I am that animal.
Oh, enough of this! I've got to get my kids!
Trish, please. I have to get into that festival. He wants it? So what? And... what's wrong with you?
I have to make this documentary.
Oh my god. How much are you gonna humiliate yourself? How much are you gonna go through with this film of yours? Always an investor. You tell me you always have a producer, a star. It's been 8 years. This Parkrat Nigel, the Korean, those perverts from the Philippines, that asshole from Texas who just wanted you to be his mistress. You always tell me you have somebody that's going to do your film, and it's always just smoke.
Either get your camera or get out.
I'm making my movie, Trish. I'm making it. And I'm doing this documentary.
It's going to kill you. It almost already has. It's just a movie. Just a movie.
You don't know, Trish. You live in the suburbs. You have a normal, whole-week husband who's a pharmacist. You go to Little League games and Girl Scouts. You dress up your kids for Halloween. I'm not like that. You don't know how I feel about my movie.
Well, I know. I don't want to end up in intensive care, being evicted, my things around the street for people to pick through, and making pornos for some sleaze bag. Thank you! Is that all right with you? Well, it's just fine for me!
What do you want me to do? Reside in mall land and live for my lawn? Be a checkout girl at the local supermarket? Come on! I die! I make movies. That's what I do. That's what I have to do.
I took money out of my children's college accounts to pay off these last hospital bills. You ran up on being addicted to those pills. Being normal, Land? Being well? Having a house? Being a mother? There's nothing wrong with that. I'm all right, Land. I love my children and my husband and my life. So don't you and your whole crowd of artists slash bums put my way of life down. You might like it.
Get out, both of you, now.
Vlad, please. Please, you have to do this for me.
Listening to you two make me forget you. I go to storage room. When I get back, we start or you go.
Shooting my films. It was for the best. I mean, look at my life. Bringing a child into this, it wouldn't be fair. I was working on the Chesapeake Bay and I had two films in pre-production and one in post. Don't bring it up. I already have bad dreams about it.
You have to make your movies?
Yes. Yes. I have to. And you're angry about my choice. Still a little disgusted by me, my life, the way I live it. What my priorities are and what yours are, Trish, try to understand. I want to make movies and I have to make sacrifices. Don't. Don't. Not today, of all days, do a number on me, please.
I am. Or angry with me. I love you. You're my sister. Land. Land lived everything for land. Thousands for film school. Mom and Ted were just working class people, but they adored you. They gave you everything. Do you know it cost $3,000 just to get you off those drunken driving charges? You almost hurt somebody real bad. Well, you hurt us real bad. It hurt Mom and Ted seeing you with those dirty losers all through school, suspended with pot. You hurt them more than you know.
I know. Believe me, I know.
All they wanted was a nice life, and to retire with a little money, to buy that cabin we used to rent in the summer. Do you know they wanted to leave it to all the children? A place to remember them by.
I'm sorry, Trish. That's all I can say.
And it all revolves around this movie. How far are you gonna go? Now you're sitting here, in your panties, 2 weeks out of intensive care. And I find out you've been making pornos, living with a man you found in a park. I have finished land. I have a good life. A good, clean, decent life. I love my children and my husband and my home. All the things that you seem to find such disdain for. I can't give you anymore. I can't put up with you and your insanity.
You were always the good daughter. I was always the problem.
Oh, you were one of the reasons Dad had his heart attack so young.
You believe that?
No. I'm sorry.
You think I helped kill Daddy?
You were so creative. The art projects you did for school. I mean, I was proud. You were my sister. And the films you made, the contests you won, I mean, I was the dull one. Everyone wanted to be around you. You were special. That's what Mom and Dad would say. That's what everyone would say. Land is special. Well, I am tired of you being special. I am tired of you taking off your jeans, letting yourself be degraded. Is it worth it? Think, is it worth it?
Trish, I am getting your camera and the equipment out of the car. You could go outside like that, but this is the end. It's your life, and you're not dragging me into it anymore.
I'm sorry, Trish, but it's for my movie.
Oh, yes. For God's sake, your movie. Please, I pray. I really, really pray that someday you get to make your movie. It means so much to you. More than respect itself.
Stop arguing, both of you. You two should be out from the Geneva Convention.
Serbian goons march through our village, come to each house one by one, smashing down doors.
Come out of your house now, or we will burn you inside them, you Albanian germs.
We were in our nightclothes. They slap us with butts of their rifles. Old women, children, doesn't matter to them. They round up all the men at gunpoint, take them to a field. Make them start to dig. My sister, only 16, so very beautiful. They strip her, make her lie on couch, and take turns with her, making my mother, my father, and me watch it all. They just pull down their zippers and fuck her. At first she cry and scream. But so did my mother and my father. But they just kicked them down and left. My mother tried to run out of the room, but they just held her down and made her watch. One soldier had rifle at my head, two had arms behind my back. So all I could do was watch too. After a while, my sister stops screaming. Just lies there, numb, eyes dead. After so many had her, she just looked over at me and said, "Grab a gun, shoot me if you can." I start to fight. I tried to grab rifle, they grab at me, I fight at them, I get loose, I run out back door. I run through woods, they chase me, they shoot at me, but they miss. I know where woods run deep, so I run there. Bullets fly by my head, but they can't hit me. I hide myself in cave, do not move. They chase me. They chase after me, they shoot at me, but wood keeps caving me hidden from them. I hear the screams of my village, of everyone being shot. I can see the glow of the flames as my village burns. I wait day till after they leave. I go back to village. Blood lines walls and ground like paint on canvas. They push dirt with tractor over and over the graves. Underneath, tire tracks. My mother, my father, my sister, my friends. Everything in my village destroyed. I wander long back paths for days till UN patrol finds me. They send me to United States. They put me in art school because I can paint, sculpt, and draw. They put my work into exhibition. Critic from New York Times say, sculpture I made out of spent army shells were most powerful work he had ever seen. I had done with my work what the Picasso had done with the Guernica. I get commissions. Albanian embassy gives me the studio because my art symbolizes the atrocities of the Serbian people that raped and murdered. No one, they say, makes art that expresses the cruelty and humiliation like I do. It's because I know it. I feel it. I lived it. No more. I cannot say no more.
That's enough. I have enough. I can go to the film school. I'll edit it there. The editing bays will be open in the morning. I work all day, finish it, get it in by the deadline. It's so powerful. Your story. I mean, it's so horrible, but it's so powerful. And I have it all.
Put on your jeans. I'm tired of looking at you in this year.
This is gonna be the hit of the festival. I know it. First prize, maybe. People will notice me. Then I'll get funding for my movie.
I hope you do. Then I can say she used my studio to make her first dirty little film, fucking fat.
Filming Nigel, having sex with those lard buckets.
Pouring flour on top, watching Nigel going around, getting back and forth, and getting squished. Good times. Where will you stay tonight?
I don't know. I'll find an all-night diner. $3 for a cup of coffee, I'll make it.
No. Here. If you sleep here. I go down, Mr. Farnes, pick us up Chinese food. A little bowl of lo mein for the bread.
Nigel, you son of a bitch!
Yeah. For you. All for you.
There's at least $3,000 in here. Where did you get it?
$5,000. It's an advance. And there is more. $2,500 every week. Enough to start your movie. And here are 2 tickets to LA. We leave tomorrow. You have to begin shooting immediately.
Me? Leave with you? LA? I want to kill you for what you've done.
Do you know what this money is for? It's the first installment on By Love and Art's God. Our baby, our movie begins at last, and this is the down payment.
I'm 2 weeks out of intensive care. Where were you? Where were you?
I'll explain. I'll explain everything. Oh, I love that script, that beautiful script that you wrote. I told you I'd get the money to produce it for you. Didn't I? Didn't I?
You cost me my apartment. You didn't even come to the hospital.
Listen!
I don't have to listen to you! I want to kill you!
Is this real money? Is it? Is it? God, and there is more. More, 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 more! Enough to do your movie. This woman produces movies. She'll show us how to distribute. I met her, showed her the films we made together, and she hired me to be head assistant producer. And as my first official act as head assistant producer of Sensuality First Productions, I am hiring you to be director of photography. Your movie is going to get made because of those stupid little pornos we made. Now, tell me, what will you wear at the Academy Awards,
Which film?
Tiger Balm. The one with the waitresses. Through selling that. Well, it's a long story, but the important part, the really important part, is the way you shoot. I sold you. Oh, did I sell you? I even showed her your movie about the fisherman. She loved it all.
My masters. You have my masters?
Of course I have them. I took them to LA with me. Why?
Oh, thank God. You showed someone those stupid little pornos of those coked up chicks getting off?
Now, this woman is smart. So smart. Sharp. Do you know what she said? You find the feelings in people, real deep feelings, and the true sensuality in women. She said that.
She did.
Oh, she's looking for someone special to make her and her stars more beautiful, more alluring. She wants a filmmaker who understands more than just lights and angles. Someone who can make things softer, more textured. So I showed her the movie you did with the waitresses.
Shot that in a night.
Oh, she loved the way you made them look. Erotic, remember? You had them put on those masks and act like tigers.
Well, Nigel, they took my rug from Tunisia.
So we'll fly there and you'll get a new one. You're going to be a director in LA, don't you get it? You're going to be making movies. All you ever wanted to do was make movies, right?
So who is this woman?
Her name is Sophia, and she knows how to get a film done. She has the things we need.
You said you were paying the rent. Just do the stupid little pornos and we'll be able to pay the rent.
I couldn't make enough money. You know how much your pills cost on the street, the ones you had to have. Go beg me to get them for you.
You kept saying you had that money coming in from overseas. You were ripping up the eviction notices.
It was the only way. The only way you gave me.
Please, Nigel, I have to have more, Nigel!
say no to you when you were shivering and had that look in your eye. That's where the money went, for your habit. That's why we had to do those little pornos and why I had to lie about the rent. If I got caught buying those pills, I could have gone to jail, gotten deported. Did you ever stop to think about that? You had almost a $200 a day addiction. 5 years, 4 there, 2 or 3 when nobody's looking, right? My God, it was worse than heroin. Oh, I begged you to slow down, to stop, didn't I? But you said you couldn't. So I found a way to make some quick money. But now our lives have changed. Because of this woman in L.A., I took our last bit of money and all your masters to go see her so I wouldn't lose our deal.
What happened to the money you were supposed to get from the sale of your family's land?
My cousins who held the deed to the property stole my share. They're using it to start a business making cheap suits in Taiwan. They did it all with bribery and falsifying paperwork. But I'm going to become rich and I will show them. We will show them. Baby, oh, you look so tired.
I am. I shot all day. Documentary on Vlad. I've got to find the strength to get it edited and scored and submitted by tomorrow at 6.
But I said that you'd be in L.A. tomorrow. We have to be there. We could lose this whole deal.
I can't go. I've got to get the Vlad documentary edited and submitted by tomorrow at 6 for the Voices Festival.
Here. I have something for you. Just a little. Just a little to settle you down. I'm not letting you near this again once we get to L.A.
You want me to do coke?
Just a little to cut the nerves.
I can't believe you. L.A., all this bullshit. You can't take anything more from me. I don't have any more to give. And I'm not making any more movies of coked up waitresses masturbating for you or 300 pound nurses you fuck while they get flour poured all over them.
Survive. We had to do it to survive.
Go. Just go. Leave me alone. My sister hates me. My own sister. I've got one last chance. This documentary on Vlad. I'm entering it to see if I can get backing. Then I'll pay her back. I'm going to make my love and art scarred. I swear to God. I swear to God.
You don't need this documentary of Vlad. This is an advance on your salary. It's set up. It's all set up. We are going to make your movie, and the world is going to know about your talent. Then we are on our way. Oh, we'll tell funny stories about this someday.
I'm doing this documentary of Vlad for the Village Voice Festival.
Ooh, a festival. Anybody can enter a festival. How many festivals are there nowadays? You won that one up in the Hamptons, and what did it do for you? It didn't get you backing. What I have for us, big and real.
I wish you would have just come to the hospital. Why didn't you return any of my calls? You told me you loved me.
Baby, I do. I do love you. I love you. I love your talent. I love your script. And want to marry you.
Marry me? Shut up! Just leave me alone!
Look, the reason I couldn't come to the hospital was because I had to meet with Sophia and set this all up. It all came together so fast I had to jump on it. I just didn't want to get in touch with you until it was done. Until I could show you I could do it. I never thought the landlady could do this. I didn't know she had the right. I know lots of people whose rents back up in the village. They never do anything to them. I'm sorry. I was just... I was thinking about Sophia and our movie and this deal. Look, if I just wanted to dump you, why have I come back with this money? 5,000 and we can start. You can buy the film and get the right lights and start. Our movie is the only thing I was thinking about. We are going to make it, and it is going to be a hit!
This is just another one of your con jobs. You ran out on me.
Listen to me. I came to this country to produce movies. Real movies, and yours is going to be the first. Don't you hear me? I am making your movie. I cried the first time I read your script. I said to myself, I have to produce this. But when the money didn't make it from Europe, I knew I had to do something, so I did. I have plans, and I don't care what I have to do or where I have to start in order to get your film made. So get your camera lights ready, and we will ship them first thing in the morning. Then we are on that plane at 11 a.m. God, the money is real. Real, real, real! Just like your movie is going to be real. I'm going to be somebody. You are going to be somebody. We are going to be somebody.
This is outrageous. I don't even have any clothes. Going crazy. The doctor said going off the pills can make you feel this way.
Okay. One time. Don't get used to this. Promise me. Feel better?
Actually, I do a little. I felt like I was going back to the psych ward.
Well, that's it. No more. Clothes. We'll get you some new ones in the morning. Pink. Everyone in LA wears pink. Kitchen anyway.
I love my apartment. My life was there.
Not anymore. Now it's in LA. Your place had roaches. You're moving way past that. The big time. Soon you are going to be an acclaimed Hollywood filmmaker.
And I can use this money to start my film.
This money we can use to start our film. We already have a place where we're going to stay, a beautiful place in the hills with a fully equipped studio, top of the line editing equipment. It has a pool with a fountain in the middle. It's three stories with those gigantic white columns in front. It's the perfect place you need to do your first exteriors.
First shot. The first shot of my movie.
Just stop getting everything together in your head. What you'll need for the film, actors, costumes, sets, everything.
I added two new scenes. They are so good. I know exactly how I'm going to shoot them.
Sophia will get us a named actress.
Wow. A star. In my movie. Oh, I wonder who. There's so many in LA. Why does she want me?
I told you she wants a woman to film her. A woman that can capture the erotic beauty of women the way you did with those waitresses. The men she's been using have no creativity. They just make everyone look like fuck dolls. She wants a woman with sensitivity that will make her and her stars look glamorous, seductive. She wants art in her pictures. She wants soft shades of lights and colors.
Pornos. You want me to make pornos for you again?
Not pornos. Adult-themed videos.
This is why you came back? To get me to shoot porn for you? Vlad's documentary has something to say. It's important.
But there's no money for you in that. Money, money, money! We have a chance to make money! God, they're not porn like you're used to. They are sophisticated, high production value adult films with real stories. The days of the whack-off cheapies are over. Do you know who buys her films? Adults. Upscale, educated, that's the new market. God, they have plots and characters. She has this whole series shot in gardens and under swaying trees. Beautiful backgrounds and costumes and makeup. It's not sleaze. It's erotic filmmaking. It's all regulated. There is no shame.
They're pornos.
I read about a psychiatrist that treats people with sexual problems. Impotence, frigidity. He said that her films have therapeutic value. He recommends them to couples to improve their sex lives.
I'll be shooting pornos.
God, listen! Just listen to me, Land. Just give up the judgment. We are going to use the money to make your movie. Class. Sophia wants class.
It all just comes down to fucking and sucking, no matter how good the lighting is.
Well, what are you going to do? You've been trying for years to get your movie made. What luck have you had? You've been trying for what? 8 years now? Total failure. Okay. Okay, if you want to live with your sister, who you said hates you, if you want to live in her basement and have a dead little suburban life filming weddings, anniversaries, graduations, and bar mitzvahs, then you do that. But you will waste your talent and your life knowing that you have a great film inside you that will never get out. Or can you make this sacrifice and work with me, getting by love and art scarred made, and make $2,500 a week in the process? Sophia will help us find investors. Land, do you want to make your film or not?
I have to make my movie.
course, amazing amounts. She finds the most attractive people. They look like gods and goddesses. She turns them into stars, and that's why people keep buying her films. They all have followings and fan clubs. They get top dollar because not only men, but women fall in love with them and keep buying every new video. Oh, they are profit. Pure profit. And she has this sixth sense about who's going to become a star or not. She knows the ones that are going to make it.
A queen of adult videos. All hail the queen.
All hail the queen is right. Sophia was totally upfront about everything she wants in her movies, but the way she got into the industry. She did her first film playing Cleopatra, and the public was clamoring for her. She's not this super die-job blonde ice queen. She is a sensitive person with no regrets about what she's done. But like I said, she wants a woman to film her. She wants to look like an aristocrat and a countess. With your techniques, your close-ups, her warm, seductive eyes, long shots in mirrors, you will turn her into Venus herself.
She is stunning.
Oh, she makes people stop in the street just to look at her. She is so sensual. She wants you to do this series of films with her. She will play Lady Chatterley, and you will follow her love life with these dukes, princes, and royalty. Oh, people will buy episode after episode, the same ones that buy romance novels. Oh, the men are gods! She's patterning the whole series after Lady Chatterley's lover. She's calling it Lady Chatterley's Lusters.
Oh, I'll still be making pornos. I don't know about this.
And Saudi returns. You eat to make fucking Fatties 2 the sequel, huh? They evicted her because of you. You want me to beat him to shit for you?
Show him the envelope.
A lot of money. How you got it, I do not know. All I know is they put this woman on street, she was in hospital, she almost died, her sister hates her, and you just take off.
I did it to make her dream come true, because now it's my dream too. I called the hospital every day, I called and called, I needed to know how you were doing. But then a nurse told me that they released you, I thought you were home. I just didn't want to get in touch with you until the deal was finalized.
Deal. So you were making deal. And you have little envelope full of money and briefcase and you come back to make everything right.
You know, that is just what I've done.
How can you stand to have this con man in the same room with you, huh? I can't.
Con? The only reason you became this supposed great new artist is because you survived a Serbian massacre, and the Times art critic who caters to the pretentious, liberal, smug literati wrote that review of your work. Oh, you can almost feel his work bleeding. You're mediocre. I know a half a dozen artists totally superior to you, but you became this new darling of the art world not because of your work, but because that reviewer wanted to be one of those critics that makes a name for himself off of his discovery, this new sensation that he found. So he picked you. Why? You're Starry, not you. You're not a great artist. You're a fad that happened to luck out into a critic trying to make a name for himself. She's going to go to L.A. to be a filmmaker. I set it all up. It's a done deal.
Have her back using drugs yet?
Oh, I'll shoot you. If you do, I'll shoot you dead. L.A. Filmmaking job.
Mrs. Nigel.
Get away from my sister. I bite. I kick. And I have a brown belt and go right for the balls in the throat. I'll hurt you. I'll hurt you real bad.
Show her the money.
Where'd you get this from?
It's an advance. Your sister is going to make money. Lots of money. But most importantly, she's going to make by love and art scars.
You're using my sister.
I know. You'll shoot me dead. I've been looking after your sister while she was taking those pills. Making her eat. Making her get out of bed. She was going to slit her wrists, and I stopped her.
Looking after her? She was so toxic that she had a convulsion, and you were her pusher. You're the man that wasn't paying the rent and said you were. Getting her to do all those dirty little films.
Tell them the truth, Land. I dedicated myself to getting your film made while you begged me to get you more pills. Tell them, Land.
I made him get them for me. I had to have them no matter what. I couldn't stop. I said, fuck everything, just get the pills, and we shot those cheap pornos. My love and art scarred, I thought, is never gonna get made, so why live?
I knew that she would die if she didn't get her film made, so I took a chance. A big chance that I could get it made if I could just get to see Sophia.
What? Who the hell is Sophia?
She is the executive producer of Sensuality First Productions. We are going to live and work with her on a Hollywood estate and shoot at night, on weekends, whenever. I'm telling you all the truth. Look, I didn't know her landlady could evict her. I thought that she was safe.
This is a picture of my sister. My sister. I thought she was...
The one you told me about?
Thought soldiers killed her. Where is she, Nigel? I said, where is she, Nigel? Tell me where she is.
Or I will separate your head from your body in L.A. This is the woman we're going to work for in L.A. She was discovered serving coffee in Belgrade, living in a refugee camp. When they saw how beautiful she is, they offered to take her to America and make her a star.
Make her a star?
Now she lives in a mansion. God.
She's practically naked, and it says on bottom she is queen superstar of adult video world.
Land is going to be her director of photography.
Last place I saw her was on couch in Albania with surgeons taking their turns with her.
The story goes that this general got a hold of her and she was completely his. Then, I guess when he was done with her, she escaped to that refugee camp.
You can't do this, Land. You can't go out to LA and film porn. You'll get on those pills again.
I won't. I promise I won't. But this is for real money. I can get to do my movie. It's just a way to do my movie.
You have to come with me. This is our chance. Our chance to be somebody.
I want to see her. Take me to see her!
No, I need that on set 3. And I need 2 fluff girls to get them ready for that scene.
You must be Sophia's brother, Vlad. Hi! It's a pleasure to meet you. I'm LP. I just love your work. Come with me. She's been waiting all day for you.
Oh, man. I looked you up online when I heard you were coming. I just love your work. I mean, your work is just so intense. Come with me. Come on. Watch your step.
Hey! What the hell? What is this? A movie set or an arcade?
She's taking a break.
No, you're not. I need you upstairs for the fuck girl. Move it there. Executioner. Lose the shirt, lose the shoes, I need you on set 3.
Got it.
Yeah, I just found it. Hey, King Louis, get upstairs. Now.
Okay.
Leave her alone. Sophia? Excuse me. He's here.
Oh, God. You're alive. You're alive. My beautiful brother. How?
I escaped into the woods.
When I heard you were coming, I said, oh, thank you, God. Thank you, my dear. Dear brother, I thought you were dead. But look, it's true. It's really true. It's a miracle.
This picture.
Excuse me. Please excuse me. Oh, look. If you just knew what I went through. They put me in the refugee camp. I had no choice. This lady, Ashley, offered to bring me to US and make a lot of money.
Make whore out of you.
I'm not whore. I make movies. After what Serbs did, who cares? I don't. Sex, just mindless sex, that is all. It's just for money.
No. I take you back to New York City. I am a famous artist there. I have commissions, thousands of dollars in commissions. I get you green card, citizenship.
And leave this? This is all mine. No, I belong here. Please. There are things you don't understand.
I understand. You disgrace mother and father. You make shameful movies with strange men. No. No, no more. Those Serbian dogs turned you into this.
I avenge mother, father, our whole village. No, I want to stay here. Dear brother, I'm all right. I'm so used to it, it doesn't matter. I'm empty inside when I do it.
What do you mean you avenge your family?
Just leave it alone, Vlad. I like it here, I make it here, and I'm staying here. You saw what I went through. Now I am happy. Please, let me be happy. LA, the money, I think. I even have a fiance, Tony. We will marry, then I stop being in these movies. Vlad, we have our own lives now. The past is the past. It's all gone now. I said there are things you don't understand. I love you. But go now. Now is not the time for you to be here.
How did you get vengeance? How?
I did it. I did it myself. I got our revenge.
How?
You must tell no one. I could be imprisoned, killed. General who led Serbs, killed everyone, burned down our village. You remember him.
I only dreamed of tearing his eyes out and making him suffer.
He suffered. I know. I make him suffer. Me. With these two hands. He squirm and scream. But I step on him. He twists in pain and bleeds to death. After all the soldiers rape me and take me prisoner, he finds me, takes me as his personal whore, tells soldiers I'm his now, I'm off the limit. He tells me he won't kill me if I perform for him. I think about Mama, Papa. I decide I will trick him. I go along. I serve him. Tell him what a big man he is. What a great lover he is. How I want him bad to have sex with. I get him drunk. Have him dress up in his uniform, march around, slowly pull down his zipper, like I'm going to give him a blowjob. I reach under pillow, where I hidden gun. I shoot him in his cock again and again. He bleeds, bleeds, and begs me to stop. I watch him die in agony. They knew I did it, but can't prove it. To them, I commit war crime. So if I'm ever caught, they'll put me on trial. That's why I went with Ashley and did her movies. She and these movies saved me. I'll marry Tony, and it will end. No more strange men will ever just use me for sex again. You have so much more art to make for the world. Go, make it. You have to. My life is here. I know what it is like. We will make a much visit.
Donnie, talk.
Sophia. Darling, you look gorgeous. But that's because you are gorgeous.
You make me look prettier than I am.
Impossible.
For the next shot, I had the background painted blue and silver. I'm going to push in on you with a slow track and an amber filter. Emmanuel will be wearing a scarlet jacket. It's going to be beautiful.
Land, these shots are costing way too much money and taking too much time. You're getting carried away.
Shut up, Nigel. She's talking with me. Go make yourself useful somewhere else. You like making films? No. You love making films. Everything is better when you film, right?
Ever since I was a little girl and I got my first camera one Christmas.
I saw the sadness in the fisherman's face in your documentary. You make me feel so much for them that I hadn't felt in such long time. The ones they fish for clams for years before their water was turned to poison. And I hear you make documentary of Vlad, my brother.
It was for a festival, but the deadline is past and I don't have the time or stamina to finish it.
Finish it? I'll pay you. I want to give it to him as present. You bring truth into this cruel, brutal world. I wish I was like you. And I hear you want to make one of your own, right? A full-length feature film.
I'm trying to. It's just with these hours. It's so time-consuming. I don't know when I'll ever finish mine.
By love and art scarred. That's the title, right? That's what Nigel told me.
Yes.
And you don't use the coke or any other hard drugs, right?
No, I don't. That part of my life is over. So over. I left that back in New York.
By love and art scarred. You'll get it, mate. You have to. I can see. He's in your soul. So tell me about your script. I want to hear it all from you.
I've been writing and rewriting it for years. It's about an artist, a young girl, a painter.
A brilliant painter, gifted.
Yes, yes, very brilliant. She goes to art school and she falls in love with her professor. But he's married and has two children. The brilliant little painter gets pregnant and she desperately loves this man.
But he doesn't love her. It's just an affair. It means nothing to him.
Yes. How did you know?
Your eyes are telling me the story. He's cruel and hard and vicious. He never did it. Because now she follows him. It disturbs his little world.
Yes, he ditches her, tells her to get out of his life and she should go have an abortion. But she can't do it. She can't kill the little life inside of her. That's what she tells him. But he convinces her otherwise.
She imagines the baby in her arms. What color his eyes would be, if he would have flaxen hair. She would hold the little life and feel his warmth and put on little blue booties, go for a walk in park with stroller, all tucked in a blanket.
Just the precious little face sticking out, so round and beautiful. She would actually have these dreams about it. And you put that in your movie, Dream Secrets.
I have that in there.
She starts to think about killing herself.
That's the end. I have the scene where she picks up a knife. She takes it with her into the bathtub. Runs the water, sprinkles in bath salts, lights candles.
Like a ceremony, a ritual.
I know just the way I want to shoot it. Candles provide most of the light.
This movie is your child. You birth it. You give it life. By love and art scarred will be your beautiful child.
Vlad told me what the soldiers did.
It's over. Life goes on, it happened. Now it's over. But I know it's written well, your movie. I know you'll film it beautifully. Your passion is in it. It is sad, but it will be a beautiful sad. This movie means everything to you. Right?
Everything.
Make it.
I've been trying for years.
Stop trying. Just make it. Do it exactly the way you want to do it. Make people cry. I give you everything you need.
What about my job finishing your pictures?
We start after Lady Chatterley's lusters are over. I'm not going to be in them anymore. I found other want-to-be porn stars. They beg me to be in my movies, to become porn starlets. They are hardcore exhibitionists. They use the coke and the pills to prepare themselves. I hate it. And so do you. You just make your movie.
Make my movie. Just like that. Make my movie.
Yes, make your movie, just like that. After Lady Chatterley's lusters are done, and you finish Vlad's documentary, it's the only thing you'll work on, period.
Make my movie.
I insist on it.
You'll be my backer.
Use your talent to bring something beautiful into the world. Be a part of it. It will make me happy. It will help me to forget. Now finish your story.
The girl.
The little artist girl.
She has to stay alive because...
Yes. She has to stay alive. I'm crying already.